Hey everybody, so a lot of you saw my video September by Earth, Wind & Fire, and I got a lot of requests and questions about how I go about arranging music. Now for the Earth, Wind & Fire recording, I did it a little bit differently than what I'm going to show you today. With that, just so that I can clear it up for a second, what I did was I took the recording, the Earth, Wind & Fire recording, and I stuck it in a piece of software that I use called Logic. And what Logic is, it's a multi-track music software program that Apple makes. It's very, very much like GarageBand. So anything I say about Logic, you can do in GarageBand. So if you have a Mac, it probably came with GarageBand for free. You can do this too, if you have a Mac. And if you have a PC, there's probably some software to do it as well. What I did with the Earth, Wind & Fire tune was I put it in this piece of software, and then I listened really carefully to individual parts. Now, this is a difficult thing to do, because it's kind of like when you're listening to a crowd of people, and everyone's having a different conversation, and you want to hear one of the conversations in the crowd. You really have to focus in on that person speaking, on that voice. And that's what you have to do with Earth, Wind & Fire, or any other piece of music that you're listening to, is I want to hear what is that trombone player doing, and I have to sort of figure that out and notate that. Now, I do that in software, but you can do it with a pencil and paper or a keyboard. Then I'll say, okay, what is the trumpet player doing? What's the bass player doing? What's the pianist doing? What is the guitar player, rhythm guitar player doing? And obviously, we all know what the singer's doing. We can sing along with that. That's the easy one. But then I kind of write out all of those parts, and then I arrange it for bass clarinet and do things that are bass clarinet-y, as opposed to, like, if I were to do an a cappella version of it, I couldn't write as many notes because singers often can't sing as fast, different notes filigree. Though, there's always Christina Aguilera who can do anything. For this, today is a different way of doing it, but it still involves critical thinking of internal parts in the song. So I'm going to show you how to do that. What song am I going to use today? Well, you probably saw it in the video description. I'm going to do Tom Petty's Free Falling. Why? Well, I was driving home yesterday. I was crossing the Verrazano Bridge from Staten Island into Brooklyn, and Tom Petty's Free Falling comes on the radio, and I loved this song forever. And just let me play you a second of it so you can acquaint yourself with it. Here we go. Okay, so we have guitar, and we have bass that came in.
She's a good
and voice.
Girl, loves
three parts.
Mama, loves Jesus in America too.
Now this is a pretty cool song to start with because, right, the chords don't really change. It's the same thing over and over, actually for the entire song. It's a two-bar phrase, really. So that makes it easier. It's just a few parts, right? We've got maybe a couple guitars, bass, and drums, and singer. So we're not going to have to do this huge orchestration of, lots and lots of different instruments like Earth, Wind, and Fire. But here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to actually make it even simpler, and I'm going to play you a different version. Actually, I kind of like this other version even better. This is John Mayer's version from a live concert that he did. It's on his recording live from Nokia Theater, and I think it's from LA. But anyway, what I like about this is it's just two guitars and two voices and nothing else. So there's nothing else to worry about, and it makes it just even simpler. Let's listen to a little bit of John Mayer's version. Over and over and over and over. But you can do fun stuff with it, I'll show you. Here's the voice.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus, and America too.
Great, so that's the version that I'm going to use today. Now, if you're going to do this yourself, pick a song that you really, really like, because you're going to be listening to it like 50, 60, 70 times as you go through the process of picking out, like I said, those individual voices in the chords. Now, this is going to be a little bit easier because we just have guitar and the voice and then, the chords that the guitar is playing. So what we're going to do first is we're going to pick out the bass line. That, is one of the easier parts because it's usually the lowest line. And if it's hard for you to pick out the bass in this, one thing that you can do, and you can do this in GarageBand or Logic or any software that you have, is you can take it and you can filter out everything pretty much except for the bass. That like the equalizer in your car stereo that's got low, medium, and high? You can take the high and the medium and turn them all the way down so you just hear the bass notes. And it's gonna sound muffled and weird, but you can more easily pick that out. Here's what it sounds like. I'm going to filter out the low, the high frequencies. Okay, so now that I've filtered those out, let me listen to this and play along with the bass clarinet. It's a repeating two-bar phrase, that much I can tell. And it does that through the whole tune. So let me record a track of me just playing that. It's going to be kind of boring, so I'll just play, you'll see the first couple bars of it, and then I'll fast forward so you can see the next part. All right, here we go. So I've recorded the bass line. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go the other direction. I'm going to record the top line. And this is not the melody. This is the top line of the guitar. And again, I'm going to isolate those frequencies, which are going to be around 500 to 2000 hertz. Okay, those are the frequencies of the top of the guitar. And I've got an EQ here, equalizer, that is, it's essentially, again, I'm just taking the mid and turning the mid all the way up and turning the low and the high all the way down. So I'm just hearing the middle frequencies. Okay, so here's what that sounds like. Again, just, it's a two-bar loop that is just the G, the F sharp. You can put in maybe the E, but that's it. It's just a couple of notes. And now I'm going to go ahead and record that track. Okay, so we have our bottom voice and we have our top voice. Let's listen to those together. It's starting to sound like something, kind of sounds like the tune. Now we happen to have picked the two easiest voices to hear in the recording because we were using our filter to filter out all the low stuff and we were using our filter to filter out the highest guitar voice that we hear. But those are the easiest voices. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to the track and I'm going to start noodling around on the bass clarinet to see if I can kind of find another two-bar looping phrase that I can record as a third track on here. Okay, let me show you. The first note I'm playing in the high note is a G. First note I'm playing in the low part is a B, so that means I need a D in the first chord. All right, that gives me a G major chord. Ah, I like that. I'm going to record that. All right, three tracks down. Let's listen to what these sound like together. Starting to sound like something. All right, at this point I'm going to add a backbeat to it. I'm just going to use my fist on my chest, and I like to do this because, you know, your lungs are kind of like a bass drum. They're a big open cavity, and they create kind of a nice thump. So I'm going to get up real close to the microphone and I'm just going to record a few bars of that and just loop it. All right. Okay, so we have all of the elements of our tune now. Basic, but we have all of them. We have the bass line, we have a couple harmony lines, and we have the percussion line. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play the melody over this now, and I'm going to put a little bit of reverb on this microphone so that my sound blends in with the tracks, which also have a little bit of reverb on them. And the other thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to use my mixer here to mute tracks, to turn them on and off, so that the reason for that is because if I don't, the tracks behind me are never going to change. We're going to hear all of the parts all of the time. And music has form. You know, sometimes people play, sometimes people rest. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take individual elements and I'm going to give them rests and I'm going to let them play. Nothing is going to change, but the texture will change when I pull stuff in and out. I'm going to start with the percussion muted, and let's just give it a shot, see how it goes. intro. Gives you a basic idea of the plan, even though I had no plan. But that's all really there is to it. You pick a tune, find the bass, play, you know, find some of the chords or the inner lines, maybe make some percussion if that's something you feel like doing, and play along with it. It is so simple and fun to do. Just have to use your ears, okay? You can use technology to record yourself. Most of you actually have this crap. Even if you don't have a computer, there are software programs on an iPad or even an iPhone that let you do this. So I encourage you all to give it a shot. And if you do, here's what I'd like you to do, please. Put a link to what you did in the comments. Make a video, upload it, make a recording and put it on SoundCloud. I don't care, but I know that we all want to hear what you've done. Okay, so pick a tune, put a link to it in the comments so that we can all enjoy it. And yeah, so have fun. Please try it, okay? See you next time.